et messieurs, les ouvreurs de piste vont prendre ce parcours très bientôt, si ce n'est pas déjà fait. Et le comité d'organisation de ces Jeux olympiques et paralympiques d'hiver de 2010 à Vancouver vous souhaite la bienvenue ici à Whistler Creekside pour l'épreuve féminine de ski alpin slalom géant.
Good morning, ladies and gentlemen.
Snow at the bottom of this course, it's going to be very touch and go with how much pressure you want to put on that ski. We have to do a shout out to the leader workers. If anybody sees any worker with those blue coats, shake their hand, pat them on the back. They've been out here for about 5 hours preparing this course.
Some wonderful shots up on the course right there. Vertical jump 372 meters in 49 days today, set by the German coach. Doug, you
got
a quick look at the course.
Train,
journey, straight, what's it look like?
It is pure GS, and it is going to be smooth. There's good rhythm. There's a couple terrain changes. We have a drop bank. There's a super G down there. There's a mini drop bank. There we go.
Thank you. Oh, yeah. Cool.
Yeah, it's crazy up there. There the fans getting set for here. The first round of Giant Storm, and Chris is all up on the top.
Thank you.
Thank you.
navigator trying to get a little Mancuso luck for today's race.
Thank you. Thank you.
position. That looked like she finally came over to the last pitch there, where you can see that you can get a good arc step. The bindings connect you to that snow.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. on skating. Field goal for Houston.
Oh! 51e. Oh! Et ici, dans la souffle, tu es ce qu'on nous montre au grand écran.
Dans la souffle, une souffle.
Yes, you sure did, because I can't even tell what it is. It was pea soup.
After 54, right there down, the racing from Andorra, Sophie Juarez.
Sophie Juarez, yes.
Petra Zakharova there from the Czech Republic,
of course.
course, caught up to her. Donc, Petra Sakoukoura de la République tchèque qui va s'en battre.
Thank you.
close, just 2/100ths of a second. It's Patrick Zettel from Austria and Eva Maria Brehm rounding out third and fourth. Just great starting position for the Canadian team coming up for run number two here.
Incredible start positions. Rick Yannick number two, and we've got all of the other three coming right behind her. I think a couple stories in this first run, and Kruso getting flagged after having such a good run and not having to run when she had that rerun. Austrians 1, 3, and 4. That's where they stood yesterday in the men. They did not end up that way, so we're going to watch that. But the story has to be great job by the course worker, but Mother Nature brought in that fog, and it was really tough to see.
Yeah, tough course conditions for everybody, JP, but we had a great run under our belt, run number two, not that this afternoon, and it's going to be a battle.
Oui, Chris, puis on dirait que Mère Nature ici a un répit qui donne un peu à la piste une chance de se faire dégager complètement cette neige, mais on ne sait jamais ce qui va arriver d'ici un an ou deux. La deuxième manche qui va reprendre, mesdames et messieurs, vers midi, donc il va y avoir 4 Canadiennes qui vont partir dans les 10 premières à la deuxième manche. Bonne performance, 3 Autrichiennes dans les 5 premières. Slovénie qui est représentée et ainsi que la France. Donc, une bonne deuxième manche qui nous attend. Merci beaucoup d'avoir été ici avec nous ce matin. On se revoit très bientôt à midi pour la deuxième manche.
Yes, so a wonderful run here, and we'll see the Canadians starting 2nd, 4th, 8th, and 9th in run number 2. So that is going to be exciting. Right off the bat, you're not going to want to miss it. As we see some replays of our 3rd place finisher, Catherine Zettel. Now, Jordan Whitley, what do you have for us in the finish?
All right, well, I have a very chic French crowd here, and I want to talk to them to find out a little bit about Tina Berrios, who is in 2nd right now. And I want to talk to Bruno, because you are here representing the French Federation du Ski. Now, tell us a little bit about Tina for the people who don't know much about her yet.
Well, Tina Berrios is a young girl who was born in Papet in Saïti. She's from ATL, she's 21 years old, and she races for France and for the club of Courchevel. Nice result, Courchevel, with like a Whistler. And they were very good team, very young girls. We are very proud of her and what she did today.
You have to be very proud of her. You said that her home mountain is much like this one, so it's given her an advantage. And I know Chris has already won a lot of medals here at the Olympics. So can you tell us how many they've won? And what would it mean to France to take one here in the Alpine races?
Yeah, so far we have 10 medals. I'm very proud of it. We think we are all good together around 10 medals. So it's modest right now. The girls and the diet, and they've been very, very, very good. And we really hope for the girls to have medals today because they are very, very good this year. And hopefully that will come to a very nice end for them.